Hello everybody, this is from Milwaukee to Nashville. This is one of our editorial videos. As you see, we will be talking about the NHL arenas today.
Yay.
I'm Daniel Goodman. This is Christopher Draves. This is Matt Weiss. Yes. And this is other Matt. I'm not going to butcher your last name.
Matt Goodman.
Good.
So, I butcher your name and you just correct me and I get it right the second time.
Well, I don't correct you, I just look at you.
Yep. All right. So as you can see, we got our first one up, and this is the Washington Capitals Arena.
With the Capital One or
Verizon.
Or Verizon Center.
Yeah, yes. Verizon Center. Thoughts on the outside?
It looks like an academic building.
Yeah, it looks like a shopping mall, or like you said, an academic building.
Like a brand new library.
Yeah.
I mean, it just, you know, they're trying to
look. The thing that makes it more look like an academic building is there's a little sign on the side that says, responsibilities are raised and skillfully made.
Well, it looks like it could be the food court like, of a shopping mall.
It's like one of those motivational, corporate motivational posters you see in those office buildings all the time.
That's exactly why I said it looks academic. It's just like, you expect it to be like a screen, and immediately, like, we have UWM Panther Arena, and it always, like, has the UWM banner showing up next to it. I expect that to change to, like, University of Phoenix or something like that.
All right, let's see what the inside looks like.
Let's take a look at that inside. The inside.
Ooh. I like these angled seats. Mm-hmm. They, like, because
I like the lower level, but the upper level seems like there'd be a bit of a incline, yeah, which is what made the Bradley Center look bad.
Well, Al, you got
the made for hockey. When you have the incline, it makes you be able to look down on the sport itself, which is a good thing when you're talking about hockey. Yeah. Because if you're looking straight and you have to watch the whole game on the Jumbotron, you're not going to have fun.
The nice thing, though, I do like with the overall Arena Bowl, though, is that it's nicely curved. The design they did for it is designed. I mean, there's probably not going to be a really bad line of sight, though, inside the building, which is one thing that any fan that's going to go to a game, especially a pro-level game where you're going to be paying a little bit more money to go to,
right,
you're going to want those good lines of sight, and this arena does seem to have those.
Yeah, I agree.
And their placement looks nice as far as their entry level of section. It does look nice to an extent because they do add in the Capitals colors. You don't see so much of the Washington Wizards, who also play there.
Yeah. So the scoreboard's kind of nice, too, but...
Yeah. Well, we're in a new era of scoreboard now, where it's just like, we gotta make it as big as the arena.
And of course, they got the LCD band around the top of it, too.
Yep.
This is what is now... Oh man, what is it? Scotia Bank?
This is Canada.
Air Canada Center.
In Toronto.
Yep. This was Air Canada. They changed the name of it officially.
Oh.
Toronto.
It's Toronto's team.
It's an air hanger.
Yeah.
It does look
because it was for Air Canada.
It does kind of have that, like, airport kind of, like.
With a building crash.
You know.
It.
Yeah. You know how you look at it, like an airport, and you...
Look, I was trying to help you see, because we're kind of like in the way to fall.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Wait, no, wrong way. Oh.
See, I'm trying to give you guys a better like idea of what it looks like, because we're kind of like
in the way.
This is one of those, like, Staples Center knockoffs.
The worst part about it is it's in downtown Toronto, but it's flanked by both the railroad and the freeway there. So the way to get to all the amenities downtown, including the Hockey Hall of Fame, which is right nearby, is going over a viaduct to get to it. So the worst part about this is, although, you have a downtown arena, but it's just kind of in a really bad location considering it's flanked by your infrastructure.
What do they freaking call it for the Toronto Raptors where they have their entertainment district and that's even a mess? It's like Jurassic Park, don't they call it?
Yeah.
That was like, if you watch, like, because speaking from the Bucks perspective, because I watched the playoffs last year, their entertainment district is a mess. Like, they had to close streets down just to get things to work.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, again, this is why most arenas, new arenas now, are planning inter- entertainment districts such as this, mm-hmm. especially for like hockey, basketball, mm-hmm. even baseball is starting to do it now. Like they're even talking about doing that for the Brewers.
They got the space, why not?
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, this just looks like a average 2000s era arena. Kind of has remnants of a glass spaceship. Oh, wow.
What's up with the seats? That's the first thing that hit me is...
They're welcoming Nashville.
Why do you look like... Why do we look like we play in where the Minnesota Gophers or UMD plays?
This reminds me of the old seating in the Panther Arena.
Mm-hmm.
Just like really...
I hate that upper deck.
This is... Okay, I remember why old arenas would do this. This is literally how they would color code like... Basically, seating charts.
Mm-hmm.
Anything like, oh, this is how much this ticket would cost. Oh, this is how much this ticket
I mean,
would cost.
It makes sense from the color
this might be a dated.
But...
This might be a dated interior
this
photo,
is true.
Too. This might
but,
be a dated interior
So,
photo.
Speaking in that, like, how do we feel?
No, that's a newer Jumbotron. Check out the LEDs on the sides.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're right.
Chandelier.
True.
It says look the like Jumbotron looks like a chandelier.
It looks like a chandelier. Don't even look like your typical scoreboard you would see in an arena. Yeah. Don't it look like a chandelier?
It looks like something straight out of NHL 20.
Yeah, it looks like a chandelier.
It looks like
the scoreboard.
The generic scoreboard you get for all the AHL teams.
But they like.
Oh,
cramps,
yeah, I've
they
seen
have it
that.
On top of like some other like hideous monstrosity on top of it,
yeah.
connecting it. Yeah.
Like, upside
like
down,
the freaking Phantom of the Maple Leafs like, is going to come swinging down on that thing.
Yeah,
but then why do you have a secondary? Oh,
their Jumbotron is literally Mr. Roboto. There's the torso, there's the head, and there's his hat on
it's
there.
Just the Fox Sports robot the
yeah.
whole
thing.
I don't know,
it's
I'm not
his,
a fan of the inside of that arena.
No, too outdated. Update it.
I mean, the seating is fine, but
Amalie Center in Tampa Bay.
Yeah.
They do have a nice downtown district there by...
Oh, you bet, that's right.
Down by the Riverwalk, and they've got a lot of shopping and other amenities nearby. The Tampa Bay ownership did put a lot of money into helping develop the area near their arena down there.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, the arena itself is going to have that, you know, more glass, modernist, just kind of glass box kind of look to it. But just overall at Tampa, the area around the arena is just very pleasant to visit.
Like,
all right, so I'm going to just talk about it real quick.
Go ahead.
Why does this look like the Amtrak station in Milwaukee?
The intermodal station? It kind of, like, again,
it's
like...
It's
this glass box, like, modern architecture crap where, like, everyone thinks that, like, yes, we're going to have these rectangular-looking, you know, glass boxes, and this is the modern type of architecture we want to have. It's like, one thing a couple of my buddies in the Archie program, both at UWM and a couple guys that are out east I know, always get really frustrated with is there's this push to have these almost soulless-looking buildings that kind of all look the same. And this is kind of a side effect you see with a lot of the arena designs. But overall, even though this kind of has that feel, it is complemented by the other scenery in the downtown area there. In,
it's like, I mean,
yeah, because I could see up over here, there's some, like,
art
over here.
Yeah, it's a bolt.
There's
it's
some like lightning bolts, and they've got some nice little walkways. Mm-hmm. And it looks like they're setting up nice in the future. Like, not to mention, really, when you kind of go to a game, you kind of don't care what the arena looks like when you walk into mm-hmm. it. You care about the product that's inside it.
When it. Well, because, like, it's not usually geared, like, yeah, the hockey is the main tenant, and that's mm-hmm. the one of the most important things. But when it comes to architecture, it's basically like, oh, we need to make a building that nobody's going to hate looking at.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, pretty much.
Even, like, when they were coming up with Pfizer Forum, I remember, like, people were just completely crapping on it. Pfizer Forum in Milwaukee. For
it
anybody.
Still looks ugly to me, but
like
it looks
I don't
like
hate
a
it, though.
It looks like a broken beer keg.
It looks like a
glass beer keg. Yeah,
it's like book on its side.
Yeah,
but like the thing that I remembered, like everybody giving.
I was looking to the inside of this arena.
Well, okay. People were dumping on the Bradley Center even because it just looked like a cube. Yeah, pretty much.
Oh,
look at this.
Nice.
This is nice.
They have a old scoreboard, but nice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like it'd be a good place to see hockey. I mean, if you look at it, it's dark up top so that the light isn't shining on you. Mm-hmm. Because when you're sitting up top and the light is on you, mm-hmm. you're just like...
You're just baking.
It's one of the better arenas in terms of the lighting. Even up in the top there, even though
you could also tell there, that hockey's the main tenant. Check out all the cooling systems up top.
This is also not during a live game here, so the lighting is going to be a lot brighter during game time. I think
one of the special amenities that they do have is up over here is the Tesla coil that's right there. There's a Tesla coil right there, and when they come out and every time they score, they light it up and it just. Which would be cool to see in person. So it's one of the nice amenities.
That would be nice to go visit that place. It looks like it would be pretty comfortable sitting in the upper deck. I have a thing for upper deck because I'm poor and most likely that's the only place I'll ever sit. So I'm very critical of the upper deck of arenas.
Now, when we get to Minnesota, me and you can speak on that. Ben.
Oh, I can.
Now, those were comfortable seats in Minnesota.
And the nice thing about
Scott Trade. It
looks like Pfizer with that stupid little slope roof. I'm not a big fan of it.
It looks like the modern architecture of an NFL dome.
That looks like it could be an art museum.
The worst part for me with the Scott Trade Center, especially when you're trying to find images, is it seems like everyone just tries to focus on the glass portion on the side there, with the Scott Trade logo being like front and center. And it's just so off-putting. You know, it's like a lot of these, we'll kind of notice.
You can tell it's for hockey with the round shape towards the side over here by you guys.
With the curve at the end of the arena's building there for it. It's just kind of like, why don't we have like more people that are like taking photos of these places?
They got rid of their old arena. What was that, like the Memorial Building or whatever? They had that was right across the street. And
wasn't that with Jobing?
Uh-huh.
Jobing.com or whatever.
No.
That Jobing was the Arizona one.
Yeah.
This photo looks like he was Greyhound station across the street.
The St. Louis, St. Louis Arena.
I've seen the outside of his building in person last time I was here for a while.
Wasn't this the Enterprise Center now?
Yeah, it was the Enterprise.
I thought it was Scottrade.
It was Scottrade before, Enterprise. Yeah. It is currently Enterprise. I've been here before. This arena is okay. The seats are kind of weird, though. I think they're still pretty dated.
Mm-hmm.
But
it was built in the mid-90s.
Exactly,
so you're going to still have part of that.
It is definitely issue. It's definitely in need for a seating upgrade if it hasn't changed in the last 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
But, I kind of missed the Bradley Center seats because I thought they were actually comfortable to sit in, but the legroom was
The legroom sucked. That was the worst thing about it.
Unless you were down in the bowl.
It looks like it could be cool for a show.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. The inside seems like it's too squared off and not oval-like, you know?
Also, the upper rafter area and everything.
Enterprise is in a good place to, like, located. Like, it's, like, it's in that...
downtown St.
It's downtown. It's in the... It's right off Busch Stadium, too. Mm-hmm. Like, that's one of the things I like about sports.
And if...
Go ahead.
1 second. Sorry, guys. All right, so final thoughts on this one.
I want to visit it in person, but the upper deck doesn't look too appealing to
me. It needs a seating upgrade. It kind of feels that way. Like, I don't know how much more you could do with it. You might lose seats out of... redoing it.
But at least the colors go with the blues. Yeah. I mean, they're at least blue.
That's the one thing that I think is a real curse when it comes to, like, sharing buildings that have, like, different team
colors. Even with us, it's like we got gold seats and we have no gold. There's no gold in our logo. There was no gold in the Waves logo.
Well, it was, again, catered entirely around the collegiate basketball team.
Yeah, exactly.
Which, that is going to bite them in the butt when they leave in, was it 2021, possibly?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, next.
Next, we got the S&P Center. The SAP Center.
The SAP.
As a lot of people call it, the SAP Center in San Jose.
It's kind of dated. I mean, even in the interior.
Yeah.
The location is... not really near a lot of the, you know, best amenities in the area there. I mean, of course, you're in San Jose, so San Jose's never really been built up as being a major, like, downtown nightlife destination. Yeah. That's more of a San Fran, Oakland
thing. Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I never understood why they just didn't go with San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
But apparently, like,
I think it was cost, probably.
Yeah.
Or they were trying to play on.
Which, you know, go figure with the NHL.
It looks like it's a museum.
It kind of does.
Like an art museum.
Yeah.
Trying with that kind of
shit. From the outside, it looks museum-like.
What's the point? I mean, at least in the middle, it looks like.
It's supposed to be like a fin, almost.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks like a shark fin.
Like a devil stingray on.
See, that would be cool if it was actually at the top, but it was just like a shark fin coming out or something.
But yeah,
it's not.
It's just like it doesn't go up far enough to where it looks like a shark fin.
No.
Yeah, it looks kind of like stingray.
I don't think you could argue it was done to help make it more earthquake resistant either. Unless I'm wrong, I'm not sure how that would work.
Oh, we're dragging other stuff.
Yep.
That's out.
I'm working on it. Whoa. All right, so that's the best I can do for you.
That's fine.
I like the shark up there. That's about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, not a fan of the inside of this building.
No, I mean, I've seen what they do with their lighting and everything. That's cool and all. And I know their out-ice projection is, like, one of the top of the league, but beyond that, it's just like...
I'm going to have to sit like this in order to keep dirt from being a crease, but...
But, eh, it's standard.
It looks like a standard arena from the inside. And where is that hook in the top? It went right up the middle, and now there's no hook.
Like, if you're making a build an arena thing, this would be, like, the autogen, just generic.
Yeah, this would be the default.
What is that up top? Is that, are those luxury boxes at the way top?
Yes.
Yeah, probably.
Who wants to sit up there?
Or standing room only or something, maybe.
People that just want to be somewhere and not actually watch the game.
Yeah, kind of like notice, like, new arenas now kind of cater to that.
This looks like a big old...
It's a spaceship, everybody.
It's a corporate office.
Yeah, like a bank.
It's literally PPG Paint's corporate office.
I don't understand, because glass is such a pain in the butt to clean.
Especially this glass.
Yeah.
Because I remember watching when they tried to tear down the Bradley Center, they tried to break it and they couldn't.
Yeah.
With even a wrecking ball, because this stuff is made so tough.
Mm-hmm. This is pure plex.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It might not even be the best angle. I'm not sure. It was the one that
I mean, the glass goes pretty much all the way back, and you can see glass going that way.
Like,
it's just
kind of in the way of the statue right there that's in front.
Well, yeah, they got a Lemieux statue out front.
They got a couple statues.
We're not speaking on that. We're speaking on just the arena itself. Like, especially if this is the main entry area, like, you couldn't do more with
them.
That costs more money.
Yeah. Well, then again, they are the Penguins.
The inside of the arena, not bad. It doesn't look like you'd have a bad sight line.
This is one where, like, they are the primary tenant of this arena.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
This is one where you gotta be screaming either black seats or gold.
Or you do black it with gold rows like they did do.
Alternating sections.
Yeah, if you see this... If you see this, they basically put one, for every one four rows, there's a row of gold.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, okay. What? Even if you just did the bottom row, the bottom tier, just all gold, and then do the middle tier in black, and then you go back gold to the top, would have been way better.
Probably some people that say, you know, it's not aesthetically pleasing to have too much of the bright colors. That's probably whatever... person they had advising them.
Especially on broadcast. Since in Nashville, nobody seems to complain.
Well, especially on broadcast, there are those that say, like, you shouldn't have bright seats down below because it points out empty seats.
That too.
Yeah, so, I don't know. Like, it's,
All right. This is one of the older buildings in the league.
Shopping mall. This part right here, where
like
you currently got the cursor, it looks like it could be the entry of a shopping mall, or
Wells Fargo headquarters.
It looks like a parking lot.
Or a corporate office built in the 80s.
Yeah, it's Wells Fargo's corporate office in the 80s.
Yeah, right.
I mean, that's, again, kind of my opinion about
London's. I mean, hell, it could even be a movie theater in, like, California where they get everything fancy. It feels like you could watch,
like, it's one of, like, a fancy Walmart almost.
But the problem with a lot of these that were kind of built, like, in the 90s, it almost feels like there was just this notion to design these things with excessive amounts.
Well, this was
glass.
Built in the 70s and then remodeled in the 90s.
Oh. It's a spaceship crashed into modern, was it a classic architecture?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, kind so of they like Soldier Field it.
Yeah.
Yep.
And I know they did the same with Lambo at one point, too. And then they went back and went, nope.
Lambo, they learned the error of their ways.
Well, we'll see one later on that's more recent.
All right,
still
let's
suffers
check
from
out the inside
problem.
Of this one.
All right, so let me pull this up because it is during a
so
game,
many
so.
Banners. Welcome to Comcast country. Well, I'm leaving.
All right. So first off, the first thing that clicks to me, I don't mind the seating.
Nope.
Seating's fine. Mm-hmm. But that Jumbotron, what is that? Because if you look at the Jumbotron, why does it go like this?
They're trying to play up the new curved, like, 4K TV type thing or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I suppose.
Like, why have a curved Jumbotron towards the sides when you're sitting here looking at the back of it on the other side? So, like, if you're in the corner, let's just say, like, where we're at in this and you're looking up because they're in the far corner over there, you're not going to see nothing on the Jumbotron because... Looking at the mess that is that Jumbotron, you're just
like
be like
curved on four sides. Yeah. It's just on the you know the sides of the seating. It's just large.
Yeah, that Jumbotron's.
This
garbage.
Is why you still weird. See new arenas now, even if they're trying to cater with a large Jumbotron. This is why corner boards are still used. Yeah, there are a couple that tried getting rid of these things, and now there's the new alternate method of having. What is it, minimal screens underneath it now? So not only can players can see it, but people that are sitting on, like, what is it, courtside or glass can now see stuff, too, without having to crane their necks.
All right, so let's see if their arena is as bad as their team. Canada Tire Center.
Are we in Ottawa?
Yes.
Oh, dear.
This looks like a parking lot.
I mean, they are kind of like a tire fire on the ice, so it kind of fits.
This looks like...
The Simpsons tire fire.
No, it looks like a water refinery.
Yeah, it does, with the stupid stuff on the very top. Mm-hmm. That could be like barbed wire.
Well, I mean, you can...
Where's the landing strip?
No, it's
it kind of looks like a courthouse, well, too.
Think of, like, the top of, like, some of the nuclear facilities.
Yeah.
Like... See that fencing? That's not to, like, keep anyone out. It's to keep them all in, you know.
Looks like
so
they're just
kind of like a prison.
Yeah.
I mean, it could be a high school, too. It does have that high school vibe,
I get
too.
That, you know, Ottawa and all that, that's, like, their country's capital. But I never really understood the concept of
but
all
here's the
cities
thing.
You could have
if you actually look up the location of this arena.
It's not actually
it's
in
not.
Ottawa itself.
It's not in Ottawa itself, and it's in the middle of effing nowhere. There's nothing there.
All the more reason. It's
again,
like Halifax probably could have gotten a team in the 90s.
We just talked about this with San Jose.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they literally just plopped this in San Jose in 93 because they didn't want to put it in. They didn't want to put one in San Francisco.
Yeah. There are some... Teams that have got some places that have gotten teams, especially if you look back, like in the 70s, where those teams that like lasted for like 2-3 years.
Yeah.
Like the Sea Lions with what's his name, who was the Oakland A's owner.
Yeah.
California Sea Lions. He built a team.
Or
there.
The Golden Seals.
There was actually a team in Colorado way back that was actually called the Colorado Rockies.
The Rockies, yeah.
The Cleveland Barons existed for a couple of years. There were a bunch of these teams that people like don't even know existed. They
even like the North Stars were like they weren't exclude like that's one of the reasons like everybody associates them with Minneapolis St. Paul when they were actually Bloomington.
Mm-hmm.
And this was
inside.
Inside is so much better.
Well, yeah, the inside looks like a comfortable place, especially the lower levels.
I would say that the seats aren't high enough when it comes. They're still kind of...
At the lower level? That
yes. Far, kind of shallow. The upper level is right.
The upper level, but that far back up the middle in the upper level, right up in that top quarter,
It almost looks like they were trying to cram a couple of more rows of seats in there, which, if that was your intent, I mean...
Yeah,
I'm not
go
sure
for it.
Why you couldn't have just had the building itself.
Oh, and
like
the big problem for them is they have no parking lot for this arena.
Yeah, that's a big thumbs down.
Oh, guess what? Our arena is the same way. We have to rely on a parking structure to overcharge it.
No, they don't even have one of those. No. You actually have to take a train to the arena.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Yeah. Good thinking for this for the placement of this team, right?
Yeah, because there's not a freeway that runs to this.
It's not even in Ottawa.
There's no road of any type.
Nope. There's roads.
Well, there's roads. It's just you're not going to find any parking.
Yeah.
You're on an island here.
Yeah.
Again.
Okay. Remind me never to go there.
Mm-hmm. All right.
We
are in the garden.
I mean, unless your
Madison
team's
Square
going
garden.
There, I want to see.
I'm
going to
give it a pass just because it's like an ancient.
Oh,
movie.
But
it looks like a big pie. It's
the two Mats are going to agree on something very soon.
It's historic.
Yes.
And it has a lot of meaning, especially to the people in New York.
Yes.
Now,
with it being so close to...
My problem isn't so much of the exterior, except for the obnoxious, gigantic, but it's New York, so they're everywhere. Banner ad monstrosities on the exterior.
Yes, they just...
And that's why when I look for a photo, I look for one like this, where it didn't have these obnoxious ads for, like, movies like 10 years ago or 5 years ago.
Okay, what's the point of this?
What's the point of... Oh, the glass?
Do you just see this? Do you see that is a stairwell?
Yeah. It just makes it look like an office building.
Yeah.
But,
I think that...
Well, a lot of the older arenas
some
and stuff don't
but
really have the modern...
Here's the thing. I absolutely agree with him. Like, again, like, MSG Entertainment just put using the side of a, you know, one of the most revered arenas in the U.S. and just making it ad space is one of the biggest mistakes they ever make.
Right. Yeah,
you guys make enough. You guys,
these
guys make enough money. Because this is MSG Entertainment we're talking about,
and they have their own network, and they also handle the Mets broadcast.
Yes,
and the Sabres,
and the Sabres. Like, what are you doing?
That's not part of the problem.
So let's get into it, so you two could go ballistic.
Because he's right about it too. Look at this thing.
I get it's historic, but the ceiling has always struck me as hideous. And it almost makes me wish that Godzilla...
Looks like something out of an opera house.
It almost makes me wish Godzilla did lay eggs and infest that thing so they can just totally overhaul the interior.
Like,
because it is hideous.
Do you know what you can honestly do with this, though? You can make this a sweet LED panel.
On the top?
Yes!
With the lighting. Like, I know they do where they put the lights on it to give, like, the glow and all that, and they do certain things with it to have different colorations.
Why does it look like the roof kind of comes down?
It does.
It falls in.
It looks like the top of the Space Needle is got jammed in.
Yes.
I gotta get my mind out of the gutter, then. I'm just gonna say that thing looks like a chandelier instead of what I want.
Yeah, I know what you want to say.
It's like someone did a terrible job.
If your mind goes
glass,
into the gutter, you know where we were going.
Yeah.
Right. I wanted to say the same thing.
There's
which makes it worse because it's sponsored by Party City.
Yeah.
Go on. The problem is just, it's iconic and historic, and because of it, they never really looked at a true overhaul of the interior. It's almost like we're going to update the Jumbotron, add some LED boards on the side, and
But they missed a perfect
opportunity. We'll put all the ads out.
Yeah, they missed a, like you said, they missed a perfect, like, they missed a perfect opportunity, and they were putting this in. They could have just did the whole freaking roof.
But here's
the ceiling.
There, if it's considered a historical landmark, there's only certain things you're allowed to do to renovate it before you lose that designation.
There's way New York City could get away with taking away its designation of a historical landmark, though. I mean, that would be like...
Yankee Stadium.
Well,
they still have that.
How? Well, how they got that, don't get me started.
It would be like when they did the renovations on, say,
Wrigley.
Fenway, Wrigley.
Just because you did some severe overhaul of the main core of the concourses and the primary part of the stadium itself. They left the Green Monster alone, and you put the seats above the Green Monster. That would be kind of akin to, you know, redoing the ceiling would be
as much as I would want to go here for a game. I don't think I could ever afford it because there's no seating up top.
Well, not only that, it's just so I don't like
all right, so did you get both arenas for New York Islanders?
Huh?
They play in two arenas.
No, yeah. I didn't. I only took the Barclay.
Okay.
Well, let's go with that one. It's easy.
The Barclay is hideous.
It is one of the ugliest arenas.
But this ain't even
in
Barclays. Oh, yeah, it is.
Yeah, this is the one I took two exterior images of just to show how hideous this stadium looks like on the outside. Now, this is an aerial view. We're kind of blocking part of it.
Yeah.
Especially that ugly hoop thing that's kind of in the middle, like where that kind of overhangs.
There it is!
Look at that!
It looks like...
It's a keychain
or like a handbag on its side.
It looks like one of those weird harps with the little thing up top.
Yeah, it's just the reasoning behind that.
It's like somebody stuck a harp in a guitar.
Almost wood like, and
the
shell that overhangs there, I just don't understand. Again, this is one of these.
Okay, so let's take a look at the other one.
Look at this.
It's just like everyone kind of pull away from that. Why does it look like that stuff the guy was trying to skateboard on?
I know what this is. This is them trying to be artsy and failing at it.
Yep.
Hey, this looks like something I'd try to skateboard on.
Also,
architecture professor will tell you that's A work, and you actually do a traditional style arena, he'll give you a B.
Yeah.
I have a buddy that went to school, you would see at SeaWorld, you walk in, and this is the kind of crap you would get A work to, and you would give
doing something that's functional but aesthetically
pleasing
a B. It
looks like something you would see at SeaWorld.
Yeah.
For a design project.
Yeah, honestly, as he
said. This is literally what modern architecture academia causes to happen.
This is, like, as he said, this looks like a Shamu tank. This looks like something you go to see Shamu.
The blue there is
like
the
an indoor Shamu tank.
Yeah, at SeaWorld. Mm-hmm. Don't look like you.
You don't
think it's at SeaWorld.
Wait,
let's just take this and put it in San Jose. There's a new Shark Tank.
See, there you go. Already, like, you look at this thing, you don't expect basketball.
It's an aquarium.
It's
an aquarium.
You don't expect hockey to be in this
thing. Better answer. It's
the new aquarium.
What a junkie.
Look at
Shedd Aquarium.
Let's look at the inside.
All right, let's yank this
up. The Barclays.
The interior is even worse because it's so cavernous.
It looks like
it's a cane.
The Bradley Center.
Oh my god,
what is that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have so much space here you could be doing something
with. Because I wanted it to be one of these multi-purpose with, like, concert venues and all this other crap. The nice thing is, though, is from my understanding, they are building a new arena for the Islanders.
Yep, and it has a practice facility attached to it. It has an entire living quarters for players.
So, Isles fans, I have not looked at the design yet personally.
I'm pulling for
but
it.
I am hoping that you have a true hockey ring, because one thing I always liked that kind of, you know, was kind of a cool thing is seeing the old footage from the 70s when the Isles won had their dynasty, and just seeing the fans all revved up and they're standing back in the day. Yep, Nassau.
Yeah.
And they do go back to Nassau from time to time.
Yeah.
All right. Now,
Nassau, better venue.
Me and you have seen the outside of this building.
Traditionally,
there's history.
That kind of bugged me when they got rid of an arena we'll talk about got replaced later.
What?
This is a certain place that we...
This is Bridgestone Arena.
Yeah. This is the concourse outside with the goofy tower.
So this right here...
I have no idea.
I actually know why it was built.
Why?
So this right here was built because they had a little tower...
Radio City?
Yeah, that used to be on the roof. And that when they get ice storms, the tower would get top heavy and just go.
So they got tired of fixing this arena, but from the back half where the parking structure is located, this is like the opposite side of the building that I've seen.
Well, this is the this is the plaza here.
I didn't see the plaza. I saw the back half.
All right, so I am kind of giving away the inside there.
It's tiny. It's okay.
Yeah.
All right, but what's your thoughts? I mean, it's properly placed.
Yeah.
I mean, the location right in general, right there in downtown.
It does kind of give you that country feel because the top of the arena looks like a cowboy hat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's also kind of got like that, how would I put it? Like a concert venue feel with the fin up top.
So yeah, you're getting kind of good like sound in there.
Look like an amphitheater kind of like shape.
Yeah.
So you know you're going to get good sound in there, because depending on how the roof is shaped is depending on the amount the sound quality.
Yeah.
Didn't we also like say the amenities next to it, because this is next to the country?
It's across the street from the Country Music Hall of Fame. You got the Johnny Cash Museum. Plus, there's all sorts of like bars.
Tootsie's was right across the street as well. The world famous. Country bar where Garth Brooks actually got his start in there.
Yeah.
Is the music hall right nearby there too? Then, or I haven't been to Nashville before.
I believe
the Country Brando Music Hall
is not far from there. The Country it's Music close. Hall of Fame is literally across the street from there.
Nice.
So there's some nice stuff in.
Let's go inside.
We'll go into more detail.
Oh, Fang Vision.
Fang Vision.
What a beautiful piece of artwork to display your team. Here's the thing. When you're talking about
Photo kind of looks a little distorted, actually.
Yeah, it's fish lines. Or wide angle.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like a really good arena.
But you kind of get a good idea of how the seats wrap around the... Mm-hmm. Or the sections wrap around the ice.
Mm-hmm.
But, oh, man. Like, as you said, when it comes to, like, putting in a scoreboard, especially for, a singular tenant, mm-hmm. almost, they hit it right out of the park with Fang.
Yeah.
Because is that logo that Nashville N there, or is that, like, a Dodge Ram logo? I can't tell.
That's the NP logo that they put on the ice.
Yeah.
That's okay. The one they wear on their shorts, too.
Okay. I couldn't tell. I'm like, is that a sponsor they got on there?
But I do like the inside of this arena. I can't wait till next week when I'm actually in the arena.
5 days.
Yeah, it's still next week, though.
All right, on to the next one.
Prudential. Oh, we're going to Jersey, boys.
Oh, God, get me out of here.
Jersey.
Well, some people are saying that they're probably going to be relocating. And
really?
There's been this running thing a while, probably nothing to it, but of them going back to KC where they were before.
Oh, really? The Scouts?
Yeah.
So what, they'd be the Kansas City Royals?
Yeah.
I like a nice solid.
It's Kansas City Squires, maybe. Because that's where they are in relation to the rest of the league right now.
But
okay, so as far as that, it does look like an arena.
Still looks 2000s era.
What is
it? It still has that.
It's like the modernization.
I know what it looks like.
This has like a
Bradley. It's like a large department store.
Makes me think of the Bradley.
No, it looks like a Barnes and Noble.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you're right. It does.
It kind of gives a little bit of the BC vibes, though, with the excessive concrete mixed with the glass.
Yes.
But the thing with the Bradley Center with the concrete, it wasn't concrete. It was. What was that?
Granite,
which they put a lot of money into.
It was at the Bradley Center. It was actually built like a bomb shelter.
I was just thinking.
Yeah.
It's like low-key, Jane Bradley Pettit also built that thing. If we got into it with the Soviets in the late 80s, they could just hide out in the basement.
Well, there was a fallout shelter in that thing.
Well, yep. it was actually funny because when they were raising the Bradley Center, the hardest thing that was to come off of that thing was the roof.
Yeah. This looks like a department store, if you will. You know, like a
You know what it kind of reminds me of?
Now that I said Barnes & Noble, none of you can get it out of your head.
No, for some of those who live in the Milwaukee area, if you know about the Steinhoffel building out in near that you can see from the freeway, it kind of reminds me of the Steinhoffels in
Milwaukee. All right, well, let's check out the inside.
It was in a stained glass water tower.
I don't know. It looks like kind of plain.
Generic.
Says multi-purpose arena all over it.
Yeah.
But then again, the Nets used to play here.
Mm-hmm. Used to.
Coming back soon, maybe. I don't know about that.
They basically built Barclays solely for the Nets.
Yeah.
Well, they didn't build that for anything. They just built it for the sake of
that. That looks like a mall. Or a movie theater.
Or Montreal.
That looks like a movie.
Bell Center. Yeah.
I tried to find a good photo of the front, the other side there off to the left.
Yeah.
And they were, it's like, is there no good photographers up in Montreal that take photos of the arena?
Or just any photographers in general when it comes to exterior shots of an arena.
I was just like amazed, like the amount of them I went through, and they're all like low res too. They'd be like 480 by 360. It's just like, that was the other problem with this photo. This photo doesn't really do it justice of the exterior. But I was trying to find any photo that didn't show, like, all the street traffic right there at, like, 2 in the afternoon.
Which, that's, I hate, like, when especially for an arena entry point, that is just so disgusting.
It's, like, right on the street there. It's, like, literally, like, a street going right on this side right here.
Yeah.
Like, if you're talking... Yeah, I'm doing it right. Like, over here, this is a street, like, right here that goes, like, right past the arena.
Entry point there?
And there are, like, cars parked on the street in almost all these photos. So it just looks hideous. Like, there's, like, a lot, I guess, over here.
At least with, like, again, I'm going to do a lot of, because all I know is a Fiserv Forum. At least when they rebuilt that, and it sounds like with the further development of their district, they're not going to have any real street parking next to it. It's all drop-off zone.
Yeah.
Nice.
And that was one thing that was kind of frustrating. I was trying to find a photo that, like, actually was good. There was, like, nothing that was, like, high res.
Again, like, just from seeing this angle, at least, you get
it's
really...
It's very...
It's academic again.
Yeah, it literally does look like a university building.
Interior... bring it down, actually.
That's actually second intermission last week, right?
Okay.
Yeah. No, I'm making
it. I like the... Well,
Montreal's not doing good this year.
I like the, like, again, these lower sections. Like, I like these, like, and just these nice angled...
It looks like we're sitting in the middle, yeah. So it's kind of like...
There's a nice line of sight from probably, like, the middle deck here, I'm guessing.
Yeah. Odd up.
And
because the lower you get, you can tell there's going to be, like, if you're... Down over by, like, if Chris can point over into his corner over there, into the corner of the arena over here. Mm-hmm. If you're over there, if you're over in that corner over there, you're not going to be able to see crap over in that far corner.
Which is why we always talked about, like, you don't just do this. You go this as you get higher and higher. You start to go up. And, like, see my hand as my hands are curling? Mm-hmm. That's exactly how seats should be going as they go up.
Well, and that's the one nice thing about the lower bowl healer. It is pretty well sloped there.
Yeah.
So you're not going to...
You know that one ride at a carnival where, like, it spins real fast? You could, like, hang upside down and crap? Yeah,
kind of gives that kind of vibe.
Yeah, it looks kind of like that, how the seats are. Where, like, it just seems kind of flat.
I mean, at least you're not going to have, like, some, like, 6'5" guy.
All right, so anybody who's anybody in our area knows that this is the place that most Predators fans in our area travel. XL.
Yep.
Because most of us can't afford the 9-hour drive to Nashville.
So it's a train away.
Good old St. Paul, Minnesota.
Is it cold there?
Yeah.
That's my biggest problem is cold. However,
see a Bulldogs game in Duluth.
Yeah.
I've been there, done that, lived in Duluth for a year and a half.
Here, it looks... Having been inside it, the inside doesn't...
We actually entered right over here.
Yeah, like, the inside, it doesn't have your traditional arena feel. It feels kind of like a... what's the word I'm looking for?
It kind of got
an airport. It feels like a city hall building.
To me, it really feels like an airport. Mm-hmm. Like an airport building.
Yeah, because no matter where you walk in the concourse, you're looking outside.
I'm also looking for my gate, you know.
I mean, I like the inside of the building, but like when you're it doesn't have that typical arena feel until you actually get to the arena. Because there's like a section where it's like constantly open to the public. And then like prior to game time, also, they kick everybody out.
The nice thing about it, though, with all of that is it kind of is open. You can kind of get a nice look at the city around the arena.
Yeah.
They do well. With that, with the open design, because it's situated at least in a way where you can kind of like see the city.
Also, if you
via the location of where the arena itself is.
Also, if you look where, because this is all part of a complex too, the River Center complex,
mm-hmm.
where they have an auditorium and I think a smaller arena of some sort.
Yeah, we went past that when we went through the underwalk.
The Wilkins Auditorium, I think, is what it's called.
Yeah, we went past that.
They get a skywalk right to their parking garage. That's one of the best parts about that place.
That's the second best part. They're about four blocks away from one of the most famous food sites in St. Paul.
I love that diner.
Mickey's Diner, about four blocks away from Mickey's Diner. You could go in there before a game and grab a bite to eat. Another amenity to the arena is they do have a giant lighthouse over in
the lighthouse.
So we got sponsored by Mickey's. I'm just not.
That'd be great.
For that pitch,
because you can see it right over here.
I do
enjoy that.
We sat center ice.
We had a good view of the ice. The seats were comfortable.
Yeah,
it's definitely a fun place to go for a game.
If you're in Minnesota and you somehow get it wrong with the arena, oh boy.
Yeah.
Like, so if you actually
hockey, but this is a good hockey arena.
When I, because I went to school up in the Chippewa Valley area, and I got lucky with KFAN student night tickets, they'd have a sit right behind the attack zone in the crease. Like, even sitting near the glass, like, not on the glass.
Like, even, like, close. Right here, if we have seats on this angle of the ice, we still get, like, a good view. Of
Chris,
the,
if you would mind pointing to
consecutive sellout of how many games in a row? Like,
where the cursor is where we sat up over here. Where the cursor is, we sat center ice in the upper deck and didn't miss a thing.
Nope, we had a great view.
And it was close. Photo does it no justice from this height of how good it actually
viewed. Go wild, by the way. Yeah.
How good the view actually is.
I actually have one tiny beef in, if you could pull the image down. I'm not a fan of their new scoreboard.
Oh, God, that thing was horrible.
Like, because the one problem is the long ends of it is so narrow, you can't get anything off of it at all. Look at the long end of it. You can even see what they did with the goal. Like, you can even see with the goalie on there. It's so compressed. You can't get anything off of this new one. I actually prefer the old one.
Yeah, they try. This is a stupid thing. I don't know. Was it Dallas or the Cowboys that were the first ones to do these stupid
rectangles? The Cowboys did the Cowboys.
Did they do a rectangle too?
Yeah.
You would be better off having just two of the things.
Just wide. Yeah.
Or you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But like
two of them,
like you see in some of these arenas in different parts of the planet, you know, where they've got like two of the things sitting there.
Yeah.
Like, if that's your desire to have it to where people more towards the sides can see it,
also,
or you do the corner board.
There are, exactly. Like, right where
you could do it, like, from what I saw, the rendering of the inside of what Seattle is doing. They have a scoreboard over in one, and halfway in one side, and then they have a scoreboard halfway on the other side.
Yeah. So,
and then if they ever have to, they're flat on both sides with a panel there that also is LED. So you could, if you're on the, like, middle and you need to look over to be able to see something on the Jumbotron, you could still do that, and you then in the middle have the unfortunate of going
Yeah.
To look at the jumbotron. How come every arena has their scoreboard hanging in the center instead of just like having one big ass thing in the corner of the buildings? So everybody just has to turn their head. Instead of all the people down here having to look up like that, when all they have to do is simply say, look in that corner of the arena, or that corner, it'll be vice
for
the next.
And that was the crazy thing. They put those things in the Bradley Center before the end, too.
Yes,
just for the purpose of the Bucks fans. And they're like, oh, we want a new arena now. It's like,
yeah.
And like, what was it? The Admirals did it for ours, and we love it over there with the little two quarters. Yeah, the two quarters.
And a corner board, corner scoreboards, I think would be a lot better than having this monstrosity that could break and fall at any moment. People, don't kid yourselves.
All right.
Choice chain motors.
Oh boy.
Oh look, casino resort.
It don't look like a cell phone. I don't like it.
It looks like somebody carved out the interior of the Bean in Chicago and turned it into a
thank you. You are absolutely right.
It looks kind of like our arena here.
No.
Because if you actually look, there's still...
It's a bedpan.
It's too shiny.
It's a bedpan.
It's a glass
bedpan.
It's
a basin, yeah. It's a big old basin.
With a huge dump of a team in it. Oh, wait, I'm sorry, I'm biased against the Golden Knights. Excuse me.
I like what they did around the arena, but the arena itself, I never cared for it, but I do want to go just because I want to go.
Just the front of it looks like you're going towards a Summer Music Fest concert.
Well, I mean, T-Mobile is a sponsor, so you have that gaudy fluorescent pink that makes it worse.
Yeah, because T-Mobile keeps that this like area up here pink all the time.
Yeah.
Like, if there's nothing going on in there, it's pink.
A thing as overkill.
Yeah.
When I'm going to a Golden Knights game.
When they merge with Sprint, does that mean it's going to be yellow the whole time?
It'll be pink and yellow and make me get a headache.
What do you get with pink and yellow?
All right, let's check out the inside. Oh, this is a home of the Vegas Golden Knights, by the way.
Boring.
I'm forgetting the name, what city and team we're talking about.
Boring.
Yeah, it does look boring on the inside.
Boring.
Whoa.
That's boring, too.
Well, I know where we're talking about next. It is boring.
You would
think
for
Vegas,
well, Vegas being Vegas, you would think the interior would look a little bit more aesthetic.
Like going all out, maybe?
Now,
I want a waterfall.
To be fair,
a castle.
You want the sculpture from the Miami Marlins Stadium.
Yeah, I want something extravagant on the inside.
You want the back of Coors Field where there's like a landscape.
What, you would
you
think,
want the center field thing that
did,
the waterfall that the Anaheim Angels have?
Oh, yeah, like they'd have some
rocks
expecting
the Angels,
to have like Caesar's Palace fountains inside this thing.
And you would also think for a team that's Vegas, you'd have a better one of these.
The scoreboard's pathetic.
Your scoreboard looks like you got the reject of the Admirals and Bucks.
But we're not sure what the concourse is.
The BMO Harris Bradley Center?
Yeah, did you get the BMO Harris Bradley Center, Jumbotron?
Right.
Did they get that? It looks like
yeah,
that.
It looks
look
exactly
at it.
Like
well,
it.
We nobody really knows what really happened to all the material
it
from it. Yeah,
it was stolen overnight. I don't know.
Yeah, it's in my basement.
Your arena is boring on the inside.
So in case you have Super Bowl.
But they also made the host concerts and other events. So this
drag it out.
Is
put it in
a
the
backyard.
Building.
I get that, but this is Vegas. The MGM Grand looks better than this.
The problem is, they might have. This might have been like
a
before
rush.
Last season. This might have been before
what
the first
said.
Season.
What he said, it was a rush.
Yeah,
it was a rush.
Vegas probably wasn't expecting the NHL to agree to put.
No, they were full on set getting it. They had the most money.
Now, Bettman was pretty.
He was
pretty hard on.
Bettman's been on that train since what, 91?
Yeah, getting a Vegas team, yeah.
So it's 91.
Because you know, like
the
getting
wants
a,
money.
Getting on my rant about like because make relocating the Coyotes would make too much sense. Wasting an expansion team on this.
Yeah.
But they wanted a successful team now.
That's why they changed the expansion draft rules just for them. And, but now Seattle's going to get the same rules, too.
Yeah.
So Seattle's going to go.
But,
so the other like, what, 10 expansion teams in the 90s had to, like, languish for, like, a decade. But these guys just, here you go. Here, right.
You pay the.
You can grab any number two goalie from any team in the league.
Or number two player.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's head on over to L.A.
Oh, look, it's the spaceship that started it all. This is the arena that started the whole fad with the glass.
Yeah. Yep. Prominent L.A. Kings,
and I
Lakers,
hate it for
Clippers,
it.
Clippers, and yeah.
And good God, it's still sponsored by Staples. How?
Well, they
what with what money?
No, Staples is bankrupt and oh God.
They offshored it all to China.
Oh yeah, they're good.
All right, let's take a look inside, even though we've all
what,
seen
wait,
it.
Wait. What are we saying about this? Other than,
I'm
you know,
not a fan.
It
looks like a glass toilet bowl.
We got the glass.
I'd say the coolest aspect of this arena is what they did on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, like the little plaza area around it, LA Live. I like that concept. That's where the Bucks got the Deer District.
Yes. Well, that's where everybody got this.
Yeah.
And people, you know, the basketball team is what has made them. They got arena what that arena is, where it's basically historic.
It wasn't the Kings.
No,
nah, it was the Lakers.
It was not Gretzky, folks.
It wasn't the Clippers either.
Was gone. Then when was
it? It was
one
Magic
built?
Johnson. And
this was
Kobe.
Built after Gretzky.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I wasn't sure.
Okay, not good for hockey.
No.
If you especially just, if you're sitting arena. In the corner.
Yeah. Look at these little micro sections. That's the one thing I'm so annoyed by.
It was
these...
a basketball arena that is kept around and based on the historic legacy of the Lakers.
Yeah.
That's if the also, Lakers hadn't been what they were the past 20 years.
This would be a hockey venue.
Well, it would have been torn down and built, rebuilt as something else by now.
Yeah. Also, you got like this, like,
Lakers would have wanted something else.
You got the Lakers, Clippers, and Kings all in the same building.
Can you imagine?
No, I know that the Clippers are vying. I know that the Clippers are talking about getting their own arena.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, the Clippers.
So this is mainly gonna be the home of the Kings and Lakers.
Also, that's
Clippers used to be in San Diego.
Actually, LA's talking about the Kings are talking about going with them.
With who?
The Clippers. The Clippers are talking
the
about.
Kings and Clippers are thinking about going bye-bye from Staples.
Well, I mean,
it's the house that the Lakers built.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. It's like then that arena will be something they'll have
to themselves.
Yeah,
that they can.
They're
going to
be lorded over by the Lakers.
It still doesn't.
Is this the current Staples Center Jumbotron 2?
Yes,
I wouldn't be surprised. And because I think at this point it's like.
We're going for
it's
mass
like
retro.
They're trying to be the MSG of the West Coast, I guess, at this point.
Which, good luck with that.
it hosts the Grammys every year, so.
Yeah.
All right.
Next.
Now to another warm climate.
Oh, look at this. What is this bookstore?
Yeah, it does have that book. That's a Malibu High School.
It even makes me sick to
Borders,
see
Barnes and Noble. Yeah,
Barnes and Noble.
Home of Florida Panthers, everybody.
Target.
Started with T's.
Let's just go Target.
Barnes, Borders, and Target Center, yeah.
It's a shopping mall crammed with two bookstores and a Target.
Yeah.
Also, look at
the Panthers.
It's
I mean,
a glorified half-price books.
Here's another problem.
Right, do you guys think it looks ugly?
Which
or
what looks
is
ugly?
It just...
The arena?
Yeah.
The arena looks hideous.
It looks like a it looks like a visitor center in Miami.
It looks like a spaceship landed on top of a building. It looks like the visitor center to Jurassic Park, but worse.
Okay, do you guys remember Toronto's old arena back in the day, the Memorial Center?
Yeah.
You, I think if any of you have ever seen, like, old photos of the Toronto teams when you've watched, like, documentaries on hockey, you see the Memorial Center. It looks like the Memorial Center was plopped in the middle and they just built glass and concrete around it.
It reminds me, like, if what is it, the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum had, a freaking...
Wow, it's weird that the LA Memorial Coliseum still exists.
Yeah. I mean, they're playing games there still. Like,
yeah.
But look at the front
USC
of this place.
USC plays football there. That's why.
Like,
too.
Bring it up a little bit. I want to see the front of the, like, the top, like, down.
Concourse.
What is this?
What is that?
What
it
is
looks
this?
Like it could be
South
a California
Florida.
High school.
Like, South Florida. They
all
gotta
these
have the
beach umbrellas.
It's South Florida.
Yeah, dude.
They probably now here's
they
the
get more crowds out there probably.
Well, Well, yeah, they might have some sort of summer festivals out there, and they got the, you know.
Okay, it doesn't matter. It's summer there all year round.
Yeah. Except for hurricane season.
Where everybody's inside. Have a
fun your life.
Where everyone's in Carolina.
Hurricane
season. In Carolina, nice.
Yeah, they have summer and hurricane season. That's all they got.
Here's the worst part about the Panthers arena, from my understanding, is it's also way the F out, and basically in the swamp.
Yeah, it's Sunrise. Yeah. It's not in Miami. Sunrise.
It's not even close. Well, they are called the Florida Panthers, remember, not the Miami Panthers.
Again, yeah. Remember what we talked about with Ottawa and San Jose? Mm-hmm. This is the same exact stupid thing. The NHL did this on purpose to save costs.
Well, it might also
Let's
stop ripping the NHL.
These aren't necessarily the league per se.
It's the ownership.
Except for Vegas.
except for Vegas.
But Vegas got it right.
But anyway, getting back to it.
And it's easy some to of get these arenas arena from the airport.
Get,
so Vegas' arena is
Chris, let him finish.
Some of these arenas get public, a lot of them get public funding. And part of it where you probably see some of these arenas not really built in an ideal location is, one, it's usually pitched as a centerpiece for some sort of development project to build things around them.
So probably,
and then they never do it.
Privately funded, maybe?
Well, this is
usually it's heavily subsidized by taxpayers in some of these cases, especially if it's really egregious and it's like in the middle of nowhere, or it's somewhere that they're trying to prop up. Like, that was the problem
with Ottawa.
Of the things in the 96 Olympics with Atlanta was a lot of the things were built, especially Turner Field, was to try, and in many cases. Not just allure, but also to try to help revitalize things like Baltimore, where the Camden Yards, their stadium was built. Mm-hmm. That was another situation, this, of them trying to revitalize certain areas of the cities. And it either, in some cases, it did work pretty well.
Baltimore
Baltimore did not, but you could argue Cleveland did work pretty well. I would say probably one where you could say it did help.
Mill Park did that too when they not necessarily to a whole thing with like County Stadium or anything, but like when Mill Park was built, they actually built around it. And if you actually look at the area now, it is actually flourishing compared to where it
was.
If you're talking about them getting rid of all the abandoned and urban decay that was in the west end of the Menominee Valley between County Stadium and Pottawatomie, basically, that has advanced, especially after they finally did carve out Canal Street to go down there. Once they did that, that's when.
Yeah, but they did that and they did it all right.
All right, well, let's talk about this.
But getting back to this, like with the problem, again, getting back to it with the Panther Arena, or Panther Arena. The Panthers Arena.
Florida Panthers.
Is location and proximity to really anything else. Even if they did see some noteworthy buildup in the vicinity in relation to where the population center itself is of Miami and the rest of the
Dade County
and everything going all the way up to like Fort Lauderdale and everything, it's all on the eastern coast of the state.
Whereas
this is further southwest towards the Everglades almost. Yeah. That's kind of the problem.
It's just an island. It's an island again.
Yeah, it's an island in itself. Now, if it was actually on one of the keys, maybe it would do.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. All right, in there we go. Ugly. Good. Next, please.
let's move it up and see how we're doing here. Oh, God.
Ugly. Next, please.
The.
I don't know if you have a seat sitting, it's not that bad.
Okay, if you're in the lower bowl, you're fine. If you're upstairs, you're not seeing crap.
It is too flat. Generic. And this is the same stadium they built back in the early 90s.
And it's the one that...
Not built for hockey, but it would be good for, like, basketball or concerts.
Yeah.
It'd literally be a preseason place for, like, the Miami Heat to play in. Miami Heat building is better.
It's one of these more generic late 80s, early 90s kind of designs. Yes. So I don't even think they were really trying to be, you know, very aesthetically pleasing.
It's just building for hockey.
That's kind of become more of a trend now where they're maybe going back to trying to appeal to either an older style or this, you know, very soulless modern architecture kind of layout that you see of like the PPG.
All right, on to the next.
Yeah, ugly.
Rogers Place.
This one does the whole modern thing.
I hate and resent this because they got rid of the house, the arena that the Oilers had for years.
Stupid green.
I get that they probably needed a new arena. I just really, I don't know enough about it to really count, really question it fully. But I just kind of, part of me wonders if they couldn't have totally done a refurb of the old arena
for
the Edmonton Oilers that had. It was just. There's just so much history. It looks like that
it could
building.
Be a hospital.
Yeah.
Now I think aquarium.
I just don't like
aquarium
Rogers
or hospital.
Place.
It looks like it could be
okay,
a hospital.
Okay, the one thing I don't like, not about this, more in particularly this photo, but like if you see that there's literally a metro that runs right next to the building. Yeah. Like, could you imagine during a game if the metro were to like wreck out somehow?
And well, it's probably designed to be like a very stable
level.
Part of the track,
yeah.
Too.
Like a
yeah.
level platform.
Yeah. But it would make transportation to said game very easy.
Yeah.
But then again, you have this nice wide open plaza too.
I mean, Alberta is a growing province in Canada. They're doing
British
really
Columbia.
Well. Alberta. We're looking at Edmonton.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Again, this is the curse of Vancouver because they have the same sponsor.
Yeah.
Yep. All right. On to the inside. Oh, you didn't get a photo of the seating bowl with the oil drop. That is one of the cool things when you look at the empty arena, which you'll probably see once McDavid leaves. There is actually in the middle. You could see a oil drop their logo in the seats once the seats are empty.
Oh, nice.
But. As far as the arena itself.
The steering is nice.
Let's kind of lean away. You can kind of see it a little better.
Or not. Oh, I see an oil drop right over here in the concourse.
Yep.
The concourse is kind of open plan. Kind of like an open kitchen plan.
It looks all right. Like the inside.
I feel like the tiering, like, you know what I mean when I say tiering, right? Ugh. Like, the angling of it is pretty okay. Ugh. The top is much steeper, is nice, which, again, as it should be. The scoreboard's fine. I think this is one of those new scoreboards that has the...
That outcropping up there in the corner is kind of a little weird, but I'm guessing it serves some sort of...
Which one are we talking about to the...
Oh, where the American flag is up here.
Yeah, up in there.
I'm guessing that's a box.
Yeah.
Like an event box.
It just looks weird.
Yeah, it juts out. There's not much to it. It's very angled.
The owner's box.
Yeah, it won't be.
How many levels of seating does that place have?
Three. You have the bottom tier, mid tier, and then the upper tier.
But the mid tier has like two different levels of private.
Oh, you have your box tier, and then you have your mirror tier, and then you have your upper tier.
Yeah. And then you have even more boxes up top?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. There's like eight levels of seating in this place.
Or well, they are they are Canada's team because they're the only ones that have made the playoffs consistently over the last 5 years.
Yeah.
Or
Edmonton
really...
Oilers. Oh, this hurts because I really wanted to get to the Joe before it closed.
This is a travesty.
Same.
Of an
Little
arena.
Caesars Arena, home of the Detroit Red Wings.
Home of the Detroit pizzas.
I just was amazed that Little Caesars had enough money to be the sponsor for the stadium yet.
At $5 a pizza, you betcha.
Now it's like $5 a slice if you go to the damn arena itself.
Yeah, that's what I was hearing at the arena. It's like $5 a slice at the arena for a Little Caesars pizza.
For a little piece of hot and ready?
Yeah.
Really?
You do realize Little Caesars does own the Red Wings, right?
Yeah, their owner is...
The owner of the Red Wings is the owner of Little
too
Caesars.
Too bad the team isn't hot and ready.
No. Nope.
Oh, good. God.
Okay, let's talk about this arena because
they're trying to do like the old school.
It looks like a frisbee. That's like
it looks like a plate.
Paper plate. Yeah, see that they're leaving the ribbon.
Hang on, it looks like somebody threw
a dinner plate.
Hang on, the palace and Joe, and went.
Yeah. This is done. A mess.
But they made the roof upside down.
And then you take the outside square and you throw in the Ford. What is that? Ford.
Oh yeah, the Ford thing where the Lions play or whatever.
Yep.
Yeah.
Ford Field. Yeah.
Ford Field. Well, I'm getting out of the.
This
camera.
Is the ugly.
Oh, let's look inside.
I don't want to.
I
don't know. Inside Joe looks uglier than the outside.
That was the other problem. That's,
Yeah, the inside.
So they did an LED ceiling too,
which is actually kind of cool.
That is cool. I will give them that. But everything else, there's nothing special about this place.
Nah, it's just generic.
You could tell it was made for the Red Wings, though.
Yeah. Oh no! What gave that away?
The fact that there's very zero
Pistons player too.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's zero Pistons colors. At all.
Yeah, well, that was the other problem. Right. Is like that was a weird thing too. Is like there wasn't really a good photo.
Because Pistons are like red and blue, so there should be some more blue in that building, but it ain't.
Well, then again, this is the house that the Detroit Red with the Little Caesars built for their Red Wings.
Yeah.
All right, on to Dallas.
No. Put it back in Minnesota.
The American Airlines Center. See, when I was looking at this, I kept thinking of, didn't the Phoenix Suns used to be at a place called, like, the American Airlines Center or something like that back in the day?
Something like that.
Wasn't their team, like the American Airlines Arena or something?
No, that was the Mavericks.
That was the Mavericks back in the day.
And then the Mavericks went, nope, we need our own. We cannot do this dual sport.
Dan, do you know what I think this
was
looks like?
Was it the Midwest Express or something? I don't know.
A high school.
Dan, this is a smaller version of the Panther Arena.
No, Dan, this is an air hangar.
No, this is a... No, literally,
not
look
literally
at it.
An air hangar.
Air
hangar.
Like, you get rid of the brick facade in the air front hanger. In particular. Like, see even the ridging of, like, the roof there? It does give that air hanger feel. I don't know if that was intentional or not, but they...
Air hanger.
Yeah.
Where's the Boeing?
With the facade.
Where's the Boeing about to pile into the...
Well, let's check out the inside.
Yeah, we should be getting close to the end here. Oh.
Air hanger.
Why is it so high? I'm guessing it's because it's a wide angle. This is a wide
angle
shot. No.
No, it's literally that high. Look at all the open space up here.
Good God.
Look at all the open, unused space.
That's our air hanger.
Dude, this looks like somebody...
Look at the roof. It's curved. The curved
air
roof.
Hanger.
Yeah. This is horrible.
Yeah, it looks ugly, gray, and plain.
To the Chicago Wolves, I apologize.
It doesn't look warm and friendly. You know?
I apologize to the AHL's Chicago Wolves. This is a worse air hanger than yours.
Whoa. Oof.
Crap. Why is my face see-through on a green screen now?
Like.
Yeah.
Like. What is this? Even look at these multiple club-level seats. What is...
Well, that's the kind of arena you build when you just basically yoinked a team from an actual hockey part of the country and build an arena for them and not know actually what looks...
Just took an amalgamation of Cleveland and the Minnesota North Stars and said,
what is that jumbotron? Like, literally, you got two cords.
It's a UFO.
You have two cords holding it up, and then all of a sudden you just have, like, a massive, copious amount of
ownership got a big insurance policy, and they're just waiting for something to accidentally happen.
Oh, what team plays here?
Dallas.
That's a joke.
My favorite is this ridiculous pennants that are just... These pennants are so freaking high. How is anyone supposed to read them or even see them or acknowledge them? And then you've got binoculars. My favorite is this little board all the way, like you can see it right up there.
Yeah.
What's the point of that? Who's reading that all the way up there with their binoculars?
Not to mention,
oh yeah, because they have the attention span of a gnat.
Here's the thing. When you look at it, look at all the way... Gold and green, old 90s scoreboard, baseball scoreboard back in the day look.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a garbage heap.
No, even the monocolor, you know.
Yeah, the popcorn bulb.
Yeah, the popcorn bulb scoreboard is better than that.
All right, so this is the Pepsi Center.
I hate it.
Colorado.
I hate it.
It looks like a Pepsi can.
It looks like the old Brown County Coliseum at Green Bay.
Oh, look, in the background of this photo, you could see where the Broncos play.
Oh, yeah.
Or is that Coors Field? I'm pretty sure that's the Broncos.
No, that's Invesco.
Yeah, that's the Broncos. That's Mile High. But yeah, it's the home of the Colorado Avalanche.
Ugh.
And the Denver Nuggets.
The home of the Colorado Nordiques.
Right?
What is this? It's just like a circular.
Dan's just like, screw this, I'm getting a...
I'm out.
Yeah, I mean, what's with the giant Pepsi logo in the middle right there?
You want to change places?
Yeah, but I mean,
they could have put the Pepsi logo.
Oh, wait, you got the mouse.
Yeah, go ahead. You're good.
Yeah, I only sat down here because I'm just not a fan of the whole green screen on the couch thing. But yeah.
Yeah, I heard a little.
We'll fix it eventually. All right. So yeah, as you can see, it's kind of just a mess. It literally is a mess. Like, what's with the glass wraparound? You don't need the glass quarter wraparound.
I think it might have been a ladder design change, and they had already built that core portion of the structure.
Yeah, it looks like it might. Yeah, it had to have been an addition.
The thing is you finish it. You wrap it all the way around so that it looks nice, so that you can present it to visiting fans.
Yeah.
You cannot present this to visiting fans.
I just don't think they felt that. I mean, it's kind of like that whole way of saying, like we were talking about earlier, it's not even necessarily the look of the building, it's what's inside it on the ice thing again. But
this,
I gotta say,
this is a blight.
They're pushing it.
This is a blight.
Again, I think this is one of those situations.
Madison Square Garden.
Well, not even that, but just like they yoink the Nordiques and they're like, okay, now
we,
what?
We need a place to put them. Shoot, what do we do?
Oh, wait, we need more. We need some more. Wait. Oh, wait, we don't have enough space to do all this stuff we wanted to do. Just add this, like, this, you know.
Just slap
this wing onto the building.
It's cheap, it's efficient.
Glass and steel wing onto the building. Like, who cares? Whatever.
I'm actually going to sit.
And then they won the cup, and then probably nobody bothered complaining.
Just to get more space out.
They probably saw that, like, well, we won a cup now, so no one can really yell at us
We can't be
judged
for it.
But it still looks plain on the inside. Yeah.
It's so deep and cavernous up in the top, though, too. Like, you're way back in there.
Did you notice, however, also that it's always empty up there?
Yeah.
Like, here's the thing. You charge $125 a ticket to sit up here.
Also, the quality of play hasn't been that good the past, decade now.
Which is why I said
with some flashes of excellence with Stasny and the others.
This is why I still put them on the relocation block.
Yeah.
Oh boy. We're Wisconsin people. We know what's coming.
Oh, and you just
Arkham
know.
Asylum.
A max prison.
It does look.
No, look, even there's the bars, you know, the prison there.
Yeah.
We must keep them here. They are not allowed to leave.
I mean, everyone is leaving that state anyways.
My favorite is that...
Yeah, actually, did you know that Illinois has the highest amongst any state for relocation to other Midwest states, and the main one being Wisconsin?
No wonder
Wisconsin's getting bad.
Well, that's why you see everybody fleeing to Lake Geneva and Kenosha.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's so close. They don't want to leave Chicago, but they don't want to live there.
Yeah, they don't want to leave Illinois. They want to go there for work, but they don't want to live there.
The Amtrak from Kenosha, you just park there and
the metro.
Work.
Yeah, just take the Amtrak.
And then hop on the metro from the Amtrak station.
Yeah.
Work out near O'Hare, hop on the blue line.
Can I talk about this? Like, do you know what's the worst thing about this? Like, I wouldn't hate this as much. It's the freaking logos.
Why do you need to tell us who plays there?
It doesn't matter who plays there. It's just an arena.
I mean,
here's the thing.
You really think bandwagon-y Chicago metro people are really going to know if you don't kind of have it there. It's like,
gee, oh, I
like,
wonder where the Bulls
like
are
a
playing.
Picture book. You know, it's like a picture book.
No, but room, I mean,
you know? Oh, but it does help like, that your arena says who's the tenant of said arena.
Yeah,
But the way they did it was kind of
probably that's not what's to be happening. A college team that plays there already couldn't have any sporting events. What if it's solely for concerts?
One thing that you'll notice though is like I saw some of the photos. They'll have like the two teams are going head to head. I kind of wanted to use a photo that showed the Bulls and the Bucks logo on the outside because I think that's what they do. Where it's like, hey, tonight it's this team against this team kind
Which
of a thing.
That would be cool.
I think that is what they do because I saw a picture of them outside and it was the Bucks and then the Bulls logo on the outside. So I'm guessing that's what they do to let people know, hey, these two teams are playing tonight. It's an additional form of advertising.
Advertisement, yeah.
Which actually is really smart.
But the building itself still looks like a prison. I mean, I'm just
like these dulcet colors. Like, mm-hmm. I don't understand, like, why, like, such boring drab color. Like, I understand that this was a 90s stadium that opened as what, stadium, arena, I'm sorry, I gotta be specific about that. Mm-hmm. But this 90s drabs arena, just what, I don't understand, like, and well, I always joke because now with Fiserv Forum opened in Milwaukee, I'm just like, oh, how long is it going to be till Chicago says, we need one too.
Yeah.
Because are you familiar with the Chicago Auditorium? Or the Chicago?
Yes.
That had more panache than this thing.
Well, and the great thing about Chicago's old arena is, like, you're kind of on top of everything, so the noise level would get insane.
The intimacy.
The awesome thing, and this is why I got to give, like, Chicago people and the Blackhawks fans big props for in particular, was when the Gulf War happened, and they had the, what's the name of the guy that does the anthem all the time? All the time? I'm not a Chicago fan.
Neither am I.
But anyways, but when he did the anthem, that place was going nuts. When
let's
happened.
Get to the inside cool so we can get about interior. Interior.
It's like they took the on top of the, you know, ice aspect of their last arena, and they, like, just yanked them away from it or something.
Yeah.
Did they have a single Zamboni entrance?
I'm not sure.
I don't think so. I don't know.
Because it kind of looks...
Right up here, I think it is. Right
here. They have a single Zamboni entrance. So they're only allowed one. You have to have a dual Zamboni entrance in the NHL to allow two Zambonis on your ice.
The original six.
So because they have a single Zamboni entrance, they're only allowed one.
I'm sorry, Dan. I was copying contradictions in the NHL's clauses.
Yeah, original six. You can do whatever you want.
Yeah, media.
There, I did blatantly say.
Media market, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, because that's a.
All right. So the one thing I don't like, and I can tell you this off top, just let's pull that down a second.
I don't like the scoreboard.
I don't like the scoreboard. It looks too NBA-ish.
Well, and also, how many LED ribbons do you need?
Yeah.
Okay, it's like someone took an old one and then stacked a new one and then stacked a ribbon up top.
Well, no, you're talking about around the arena itself. You got, like, one way to hell up there. You got one right there above the lounge.
Up there is standing room only. This is their standing room only all the way up there.
But that's three LED ribbons around
the arena. You don't need that many ribbons, though.
I actually have not been in the United States.
I have no reason.
I've never been either.
I almost wanted to see a Ducks Hawks game there once.
On to the, I'm waiting for the summer. Let Chris open this. This is the Calgary Saddledome.
Yeah, this looks like a couple of Pringles potato chips stacked on top of each other.
It actually just looks like a giant Pringles.
It looks like, it looks like a giant stack
it looks
of Pringles
like a saddle.
Potato chips.
That's, I think
that's
kind
the
of the
point.
Whole saddle dome. Yeah.
Because they're like, again, like you're talking about design.
I mean,
this is one where they actually sat down.
But it looks like potato chips stacked on top
of
each other.
I think they probably did want to kind of play some sort of homage to the
Calgary
people, then just the people in that part of Canada as well, by having the whole Saddle Dome as
because
kind
they're
of a
really big for
the
rodeos
region
out there in Calgary.
Yes,
yeah.
In fact,
I have no issue with the name. And the building looked unique.
In fact, one of their one of their primary things that goes on here is like roping. What is it? Rodeo, like rodeo drive.
Yeah, probably the pro bull riders tour too.
Yeah,
yeah. The thing maybe is just
Hey guys, we're having this some would be tech a scenario. Issues, so I'm gonna actually go full screen for the rest of this video. I'm running into green screen tech issues with people's faces going clear.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'm sorry, I sat down here because we should have been audio this whole time.
We've been vaporized.
Yep, so we're actually,
Yeah.
Wow, look at that. You can see the whole photo, no problem.
Yep. You can see two photos, too.
Yep, so I actually have to move this back down.
Yeah.
And we can just go to the next one.
Yeah, let's go to the inside.
Let's take a look at the inside. That way, now you guys can see everything we see.
Yeah.
Like, because we got a new arena coming for Calgary.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, because otherwise they had to leave.
Yeah. Because this one actually had a bad stroke of luck because it was flooded.
No, I would actually like to go to an event here because even the upper deck looks like it would be kind of nice.
And close.
Yeah.
It's a very intimate arena, and that's like one of the best things
that's a got plus. For it.
Oh, by the way, if you're going to go there, I actually want to take in the Calgary Hitmen.
Yes.
And
Teddy Bear Toss.
And the Teddy Bear Toss night.
Good luck getting a ticket, though.
Yeah, good luck getting a ticket. But their teddy bear toss night, you're looking at anywhere between 15,000 to 20,000 bears being tossed in the ice at one moment.
So you're saying Calgary might lose? Might have to move to a different arena?
No,
they are getting a new arena because the Olympics are coming there.
Yep.
Okay. Hey, it looks like they only have one Zamboni entrance as well. I can't judge.
Can you imagine how that nice that'd be to get the Olympics twice, like in a lifetime, in the same town? And
Yes.
It's like they got it in the 80s, now they're going to get it again. It's like.
So, well, but that'll be the same time they win the cup because that's what happened.
So, yeah, I can't judge too much on this arena, especially as we're coming out of it. But it's definitely far from the worst arena. This is a very...
As far as retro arenas, it is a nice one.
It's very intimate.
If they're getting a cup, that means Connor McDavid moves to the other Alberta team.
Going to Calgary.
All right. Oh.
Yeah, we're going to Columbus. Yay. Look at all this traffic, because that's exactly what makes the aesthetic of an arena very much, you know...
Well, it is located in the downtown Columbus. Yeah. I've been in this area last summer.
I'm so
picky. The cities that could have gotten a team that
it should have been Cleveland.
Because you guys can't see it, but I'm literally pulling my hands back and forth in a tug of war. That's all it was. It was a tug of war between Cleveland and Cincinnati. They couldn't pick which one they wanted to do it.
So they went instead of a larger city.
They pulled an Ottawa.
Probably a lot of Ohio State bundlers maybe in the mix with that.
Yeah, because this arena is actually located on literally a couple blocks from Ohio State's
also, doesn't Big Ten Hockey host their thing here every now and then?
Yeah.
Which is annoying because they don't want to put it in the United... Or no, they actually did have it in the United Center once.
Well, yeah, but they don't want to do it now. And then when you go there for like the tournament, it's like Badgers and Buckeyes. It's just all Buckeyes fans. And then you have the Badger band over in the corner.
Well, hold your breath on that because Frozen 4 might actually return to Pfizer.
Yeah. But I do like this area. Just the area of the city. There's a lot to do down there.
Whoops.
The arena looks...
Well, we jumped ahead. As far as the outside goes, it's not the worst we've seen.
No.
It's not the worst, but there's a lot of things going on.
It looks like a bunch of giant foam booths stacked up along the side.
Yeah. Actually.
Train station.
No, it looks like the King's Center, King's Court Center, the London train station.
Yeah, it looks like a train station. That's what I said.
I mean, it don't look cool.
It's got a lighthouse.
I actually like Columbus.
It's weird. It's just a weird looking
What's up with the blimp?
That's a Zeppelin. We have one too, Dan. Don't you know?
Yeah, but we don't fly ours during the games.
I think it might actually be in practice.
Don't hate on them that hard. Their attendance isn't that bad.
You can get tickets for like $10.
This is the Red Wings.
Even when the Red Wings are bad now.
The Red Wings will go there when the Red Wings are town just to boo their own team.
Yeah, that and the fact that it's expensive going to see a Red Wing game.
Yeah.
All right.
I've looked into
Onward and outward.
Could you argue that they're now Nashville North instead of Detroit South?
Because it's more fun to toss catfish than it is an octopus.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going outward to Carolina.
My buddy went there for a game earlier this year. He didn't really have too many complaints. The problem is there's like nothing really around anything in general in Raleigh.
Oh, so it was one of those, another one of those
islands.
Not necessarily. It's just Raleigh. There's like, it's not Charlotte. It's, yeah. Well, the tobacco farms are over by Charlotte more than Raleigh, to an extent. Yeah. But, like, Raleigh, it's, like, Raleigh's kind of, like, this weird, like, bigger city. It's, like, there's, like, not a lot. There's just a lot of people there.
This isn't, like, one of those arguments, again, where I talk about either expansion or relocation, where it's just, you guys couldn't.
Hartford has
you
a legitimate.
You couldn't have tried to make this look more like Hartford's arena.
Yeah.
Connecticut has the most reasonable axe to grind out of every single team that has had their franchise relocated.
All right, so let's take a look at the inside.
Generic.
Boring.
Too low.
There is way
again,
too
again,
little.
Again, NHL Create Arena generic start screen.
Yep.
With red seats.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and it's well, NHL 20, when you go to expand your franchise, when you go to do expansion franchise, first thing you see is those red and blue seats and tiers, like a triple tier arena that goes as far as the eye can see.
Yeah.
And by the way, by the time you get to the top, you can't see crap.
It's just too little, because I always consider the top ring general admission. Like, that's always been my way of grading things. Why so little general admission? Why so little 400 level?
Because this is one thing I don't understand with some teams, where some of the Canadian teams and teams like Minnesota or just some of these areas where they're going to sell a lot of things even if they're terrible. Why they stick to this capacity? The number of seats in these arenas, because even you look at some of the older arenas, they had higher capacity.
Yeah.
So it's just like, it's kind of like that, like you're talking about. It's like, well, why don't you have more seating up in the higher areas? Because if you're trying to grow your fan base, let's say, why would you limit the number of fans to get in there? Because you can still probably charge the same price point per ticket anyways, and still get those seats filled. And if nothing else, maybe you could even, like we're talking about, like with the general admission, maybe you could lower the upper deck seats maybe a buck or two, because you're going to raise them as time goes on, just due to inflation.
But you want to fill the house.
Yeah, and it's just like, there are some of these arenas, it's like, okay, what? You don't want to have a bunch of empty seats when you're bad up top? It's like, no one pays attention to who's in the top level of the arena. Everyone pays
because
attention to who's in the bottom.
Because it's also light. You're also
the
light.
Camera level. It's all the camera.
Not only that, because I know.
It's like, are they terrified that like no one's going to buy the more expensive seats down below? But that's
but
BS.
Those always.
BS, because the bottom seats are usually the ones that get more heavily sold anyways.
They're the most blatantly empty.
Yeah, it's like one or the other.
Yeah, like in Arizona, people will buy the top seats and then move down.
And even if that's your concern, if your team's doing poorly, just do some promos to sell the seats.
Also, they're playing the Coyotes this year. On
to the next.
But can I, one more,
how many
one last
teams
thing?
Do we have to go?
Six or seven.
One last thing. So, like, as we're talking about this...
I do want to check this out, just because of the whole celebration that the team does, where they're like...
Oh,
you know
that.
The post-game shenanigans they do?
Yeah.
But, no, like, the thing that we're talking about with seating capacity, like, more arenas I'm starting to realize, like, if you're not in a mass metro, like New York, Texas, or California, or whatever... Mm-hmm. They're starting to shrink the arenas now.
Yeah.
Like Bradley Center to Pfizer, they took out, what is it, 1,000 seats?
Yeah. Well, think about this. Miller Park from County Stadium, they knocked out like 10K
seats. No, County
Stadium
had way more seats.
I was saying that.
That's what
Miller
and
Park
we lost
like
even 10,000. More seats.
10,000.
We just lost even more seats this offseason. They took out left field. Or half of left field bleachers.
They did?
Yeah. For
the stupid restaurant?
No, for Miller Light Landing.
The Toyota Tundra territory. I thought that's all they do is rename
the Miller Light
in left field.
In left field, yeah.
By where the stupid restaurant to be named later is.
Yeah.
Restaurant.
That's probably an unpopular take with some people. I'm a blue seat holder.
But the, here's the thing. With the restaurant to be named later, do you know who's naming it? Bob Uecker.
Well, yeah, that's... That's nice. That's... Well, yeah, like the player being named later. Yeah. Yeah. The thing that's going to be a bummer is it's going to be
outsourced staff. Onward and outward to Buffalo.
Well, I'm not going to say anything because I'm afraid to.
You don't want to die.
Buffalo.
Yeah, I don't want to. It's a train station. It's like a high school.
As soon as Toronto finally figures it out and wins the cup, they're going to have the longest drought because they've never won one.
No. 70-71? That would be debunked to
Minnesota or Columbus.
Yeah.
Minnesota based on the split.
Well, technically, I'd just argue that Minnesota was the same franchise as Dallas. But if you want to go that route,
because Minnesota,
you got to factor in that. No, you got to factor in the gap years though, which would put them with less years since Buffalo came in 70-71.
Well, let's talk about the arena.
Yeah, I've actually been here.
Yeah.
Outside, not so good. Mm-hmm. Inside, wow. Really good seats. Mm-hmm. Angled perfect.
All right, well, let's check out the inside.
It's Buffalo, so the outside can't be very good.
Well, here's the thing. The reason they have all of the concrete and the brick and everything, I found that out. The Buffalo winters are monster.
So it's insulation, basically.
Yeah.
Not only that, but this sheer amount of snowfall they get in that area from the lake effect.
Yeah, you don't need anything to crumble like that. Crumble, corrode anything in Minnesota.
Yeah, because if you get even with the glass here, they said that it takes like 9 hours to clear it off when they get a foot of snow.
Well, yeah, especially if the winds are coming off of that direction, hitting against the glass, it can just...
Yep. Depending on the inside,
I love that top level.
Yeah, that top level does look kind of nice. I just wonder what the leg room's like for us taller people.
Well, if you you can kind of see the leg room from on the side here. There's actually a pretty good chunk of leg room there.
It's kind of older, but it does look kind of nice. That it's kind of weird seeing that corner in the upper right, kind of above your mouse cursor. Yeah. It's just weird. It just looks weird.
This used to be a stage right here. Back with the old days, they used to have little concerts and stuff. But since when Buffalo Wild Wings became a national conglomerate, they dropped the sponsor with the Sabres and just walked. And now they
don't do the little concerts in the corner.
No, because that's who the Buffalo Wild Wings was paying to do it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So now it was
the Buffalo Wild Wings and the Wings sponsor concert.
Hey, Dan, I'll go there with you if you want to go next season.
You could get tickets right now for $6.
Which is kind of a bummer.
Dude, don't make that hamster jump on the wheel in my head. You and me might need to take a train. Sorry, Tina, saving you a drive.
Train, planes, and automobiles.
Yeah, right. Yeah. We'll take an Amtrak. I'll save Tina to drive.
Just get on an Amtrak and just be able to, snooze for a day. Grab a Game Boy.
Get, one of those family cars, bring the boy and Tina. We just catch a train to Buffalo.
Yeah, because, the one thing I really liked about their arena when I went, which was in, 2009, the one thing I really liked was how intimate the atmosphere is. Now, you wouldn't think it because of the sheer size.
Again, just the top. I know I was focused on the top tier, but that's just people looking down on you.
But, if you actually look in the lower left corner, when the seats bow out towards the back end, what happens? Flat. They get flat. What happens when they get flat?
Do you want to pop the door again? It's getting a little warm in here again.
So they get a little flat, and it's actually, I've heard that it gets loud in there. The fan base is very passionate.
So you said you were there. What do you mean you heard it gets loud?
Well, when I went there, it was preseason.
Yeah. There's nothing to do in Buffalo.
They were at Bills game.
Oh.
It was on a Sunday.
Who the hell wants to go to a Bills game?
Same Bills people. Fans.
Yeah.
The Bills Mafia. Hey.
Oh, you Bills mean those Mafia. Drunks that pass out in the parking lot instead
do
of
pro wrestling
going
moves?
Into the stadium?
Hey, They love the Dudley Boys out there, man.
Yeah, right.
Doing 3D into tables and crap.
But the one other thing is you see this up here? All these little metal marks?
Yeah.
Those are actually organ pipes.
Nice.
Those are all organ pipes.
What?
Yep.
It's a little weird.
Because they still have an original organ in the building, they put organ pipes up there so that the organ sounds better.
Oh, for resonation.
Yep. So they did everything they could to make this as pure hockey as you could.
Dear Milwaukee Admirals, Gullhorn first, organ pipes next.
Yeah. All right, TD Garden.
Now, this is going to sound a little hypocritical from some of the takes I've made, but...
I do like the glass of the LED there.
Well, that's kind of part of what I'm getting to. They kind of do play up kind of that, you know, they kind of balance it well is what I'm trying to get at, of kind of that older feel of the Boston Garden with a little bit of some of those modern aesthetic looks to it. And the thing about the TD Garden is they clearly did care about trying to give a little bit off of the old Boston Garden vibes with the design of that stadium, which probably also kind of goes hand in hand with how they tried to be respectful with the Red Sox fans when they did the redo and a revamp at Fenway. It's just gorgeous there. You can just see with the vicinity there with the water and everything and just the concourses and just how it is down there in the just the downtown area. It's just very, very well done. There's, you know, not a huge, but a, you know, modest, you know, plaza.
It's not overkill.
No.
No, none of this is overkill.
This is aesthetically beautiful.
This is what, if you put perfect
order. I mean, I probably was a little biased in terms of the photo shot I chose to take, but it's also because a lot of the other photos that were out there weren't very well taken.
I think even then with this shot, it really kind of gives it a more open feel. Mm-hmm. And it shows that they were really adamant about, you know, including the water in some way.
Well, and the best part about it is that during, like, summer, if they're making a playoff run, and you go outside there, you grab a bite to eat or something, one of the restaurants down there, oh, gorgeous.
All right, let's take a look at that. Oh, wow.
This is one, again, I wish they had yellow seats. But then again, because of the Celtics, you can't, so generic black.
Kind of from this angle, it looks like a donut. Didn't
the Garden, they had yellow seats at one point?
I thought they did. Yeah.
The old Boston Garden, I thought they had yellow seats.
Well, here, even, what you do is you do what the, you know how you can come in with those, what was those seat covers?
Yeah.
You do the little seat covers, and you do striping all the way up. Awesome. And then, so one stripe, what you do is you can pull them off, green, yellow, green, yellow.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to spend the money to be able to have to take them on and off every other game between them and the Celts. Yeah, original six, yeah.
They got the money to do it.
They have cleaning crews that go up and down these aisles. I mean,
how hard would it be to, like, look, we'll give you 15 an hour plus double overtime. You do this.
It's Boston. They could afford to pay double overtime.
Yeah, but they own, because this is a professional sports team owner.
Is this rather a current, than a fan? Is this a current? Jumbotron's so small.
Yeah, that's the one thing I was about to say. I don't like is that Jumbotron.
Also a ribbon.
Yeah,
I mean,
double ribbon.
Never liked double ribbons.
This is the thing, though, with Boston is it's just they do such a good job with the design of the arena overall that
I'll give them that.
I can't. I just even the layout and the interior, though, there's not really like a bad view. And again, they tried to kind of even in the interior kind of have a little bit of that Boston Garden with the upper deck, the way it's kind of laying out up there, from my understanding.
Yeah.
I may be a little bit wrong, so but they just did such a good job trying to balance it.
I know how Matt's going to feel.
I've been here. I tried to find a proper photo that's more recent with all the development they built up around the arena, but the sheer amount of advertising boards that are in the plaza there was just so hideous that I couldn't find a photo that didn't make me angry. Like, actually, I got triggered, like, low-key triggered, looking at the photos that are more recent of the plaza. Because I went there, a lot of this was there with all the built-up and the development they put around the arena here.
Yeah.
And, of course, the Cardinal Stadium is, like, right there, I guess.
Another ugly mess.
I think it's the Cardinal Stadium. It's right next to it there. I think that's the Cardinal Stadium, yeah. And there's plenty of parking there.
Isn't it right off the freeway, too? Yeah.
It's Glendale, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's plenty of parking there. The thing is, though, with everything that's built up there, I wish there was a photo that just didn't, that if you could just Photoshop out those hideous billboards that were, like, in the way in the plaza of getting a good shot of the arena. It is actually a really nice area around the arena down there. When I went there, let's see, it would have been 4 years ago. I went there twice. Actually, I went there twice. I went there in 13, and actually, no, it'd be almost five years now. I'm 15. It's really nice. The plaza around the arena, lots of good restaurants, all that down in there. But yeah.
All right, let's talk about the architecture.
Mm-mm. We're gonna talk about the bad part.
Why does it look like an IMAX theater?
Now that I see it, I see it. Okay, right over here in the far corner by the palm trees, it's in the circle out. It looks like an IMAX
theater. It looks like a theater building. Yeah. Like, what movie theater building?
All right, let's take a look at that inside, because we're pushing an hour 45 now.
Because the movie inside this building
looks development worse. Around it masks how hideous it actually looks, though.
Okay, that's not a really telling photo, but...
Yeah. Nothing special. Generic.
I mean,
generic.
When you don't have many people going to the games, your sample size of quality photos is also going to be very low.
Exactly, because...
Oh, God, help
us. And that's not me even trying to bait or say something insulting. I'm being realistic.
Even they're winning now. And
get some of them aging retirees that Bird watch to take some good photos.
Remember what I said about, you know, them relocating this to Vegas, but they didn't want to because they wanted a guaranteed good team? Well, now they look stupid because Arizona does have a good team.
And a bright future with more prospects coming because if you see Tucson.
Yeah, which just relocate them to another place because what a waste of time this franchise is.
All right.
Unfortunate, too, because now they've got a built solid team. Let's get
poor on. Shane Doan. He could have had some good guys around him.
It's a Bradley Center.
Yeah, right.
It is the Bradley Center. It's the Bradley Center West.
Home of the Anaheim Ducks.
Yeah. It's Arrowhead Pond. Always Arrowhead Pond. It will never be Honda Center to me.
I have so many mixed feelings about the Honda Center being a Ducks fan.
Yeah.
It's just... There's, like, here's the thing. I like the aspect that there is, like, a halfway decent amount of actual parking by the arena.
Fair.
But then there's, like, not that much around it. And there's, like, residential housing nearby.
So let me ask you, was your first introduction to this arena also from D2?
Yep.
Yeah, because I was, like, what, 8?
I remembered seeing this for the first time, and I'm just like, wow, this is a hockey arena.
Yeah.
I like this photo because it shows that, like, the mountain ranges in the back.
Yeah,
that's why I picked this photo.
It's a nice photo.
There wasn't, again, it's like, I don't know if anyone's watching this that is actually skilled with photography, but you could probably do some good work for yourself just actually taking halfway decent photos of, like, hockey arenas around North America.
Because
it's like, for whatever reason, like, in the interior, you'll usually get good photos of when there's a basketball game.
Yeah.
Like, the basketball is like, but it's like anytime you have an exterior shot of these arenas or in the interior, like there's never really a quality shot of them.
Well, okay. First question.
I don't really have an issue with the interior of this.
I do have a question.
Yeah.
Why
those
red?
Pillars, I believe.
I think it's just a test ribbon. Okay.
No, the ribbon's probably an ad.
But then again, double ribbons again.
Up top, is that the orange?
Yes.
The painted orange, yeah. That they started doing.
And the club seats are orange, too.
Yeah, that was that thing they started doing in the mid-ish 2000s.
If I'm not mistaken, aren't the Ducks the primary tenants of this facility?
Only.
Yeah, primary,
tenant,
yeah.
Only
tenant, yeah.
Because they don't even do concerts in this building.
Nope.
Oh, that's even news to me. I didn't even know if they didn't do anything else in there.
The only other thing that's ever gone in there is
probably
pro wrestling.
Events.
It's pro wrestling.
Pro wrestling, not Disney on Ice.
No.
No, they were Disney on Ice when they were filming this. Really.
They were.
In this building.
Disney on
or
Ice.
When Disney owned the team.
No, because they actually filmed, what is it, they filmed D2 in this building.
Because they made it as if they would ever host, like, some international hockey.
Yeah, but when Disney owned
thing.
The Ducks, that was technically Disney on Ice.
That's kind of part of the joke, too,
Oh, we're going to Winnipeg.
The Moose.
I want to go there just because that arena looks kind of like the top part could be a roller coaster.
Dan, it reminds me of the Rec Center.
I want to go
Does.
It looks like a shopping center.
It looks like the Rec Center.
It does. If anybody doesn't know, the Rec Center...
all that angst and desire to have a team come back, and that's what your arena looks like outside. I mean,
it was kind of a rush job on the NHL's part because Atlanta was losing their team. Their owner got caught for embezzlement and went bankrupt.
Oh, is that why?
Yep, so that's what happened there.
Yeah, they didn't want that guy that wants a team in Hamilton, Ontario to get him.
God forbid the talks of another GTA.
That just looks like a plain...
Or Golden Horseshoe, by the way.
Yeah.
All right, this looks like us when we played in the AHL.
Yeah,
or in the Bradley Center.
Yeah,
us in the Bradley AHL.
It's just like generic.
AHL big arena.
What is with the weird wraparound seatings on the second level?
I haven't figured that out, but I have figured out whenever I watch a Moose game, that they have no camera down on that far side.
That's a big party foe.
So, yeah, all their cameras are like right at the thing.
You gotta find a way to get drunk.
Alright, next.
Rogers Arena Part 2.
Yeah, I could not find a good, really, again, I couldn't find a really good photo. And this was like, they all were
this
like.
This is right off of Pot Valley.
They were all like, almost every photo I found that was like anything, they were trying to like incorporate it in the skyline. So it wasn't a really good view of the stadium up close itself. And then there was this other one that kind of looked good, and then I looked at the bottom, like, oh, that's like the maintenance entrances down at the bottom.
Yeah.
I'm like on this other side of this building or something.
Because we recently had a Nashville game here. Do you remember, like, because they do the exterior too. Mm-hmm. Isn't it more circular? It's a kind of a circular
building. On the other part of the building, yeah.
I'm not a fan of those. Because
I hate rectangular buildings. Square buildings are okay.
Circular buildings.
But
though. Circular
buildings drive me nuts.
This is probably not a really true, accurate, like, good feel for what the arena really looks like on the rest of it.
Because the concourse is what takes up that circle.
Well, that's the thing. The rest of the arena is very circular. It's just all the pictures are just pretty low quality.
But because we were recently watching the Predators game, and, like, they always do
I just kind of like this shot because it actually showed, like,
the Nets.
I don't know. It just, like, this... It actually showed, like, hey, there's actually something going on.
No. This is one of the, like, I still stand by it that this, like, this interior is one of the best interiors of the Canadian hockey teams.
Mm.
Like, they maintain, like, one of the, like, look at these towering seating sections.
Well, they have to because they can't win anything.
They wasted Naslin, Sedin, the other Sundin.
Luongo.
Beret.
Hamhuis in his prime.
Yeah, Hamhuis in his prime.
Pavel Beret and all of them back in the 90s.
Trevor Linden. Igor Larionov.
But they're as old as the Admirals.
Yep. They're celebrating their 50th season, as you can see right there. This is from this year.
50-50 raffle.
Alright, so this was our last arena. Overall, everyone gets to get one pick because we're running short on time and I don't want to hit the 2-hour mark. Favorite arena, least favorite arena.
I got mine.
Go.
Favorite arena, XL Energy Center.
Least favorite.
United Center.
TD Garden, it's not even close. Least favorite, God. You're making it hard because there's so many that I just think are atrocious. I'm going to say just, like, take your pick based on what I said and just kind of roll the dice on which one I actually think is horrendous.
All right, Chris?
All right, I'm going to say probably the Saddle Dome, just because it looks interesting.
Yeah.
It looks like an interesting place to go to.
Least favorite.
This is totally because I'm biased against this team, but United Center.
It looks like a Max Penitentiary.
But I do want to go to the Saddle Dome because it looks like it would be kind of cool to go to.
It's like one of those jails that Michael Jordan was trying to build.
Hold on, no. Least favorite aesthetically, let's just say probably the Pepsi Center.
Because again, that circular dome looks unfinished.
It just looks so hideous.
It's slapdash.
Barclay.
Yes, Barclay's my least favorite.
Barclay,
I take that back.
I'll actually change mine to Barclay because how many billions of dollars went into that?
Oh, wow. Seven.
Barclay.
Barclay.
That's my polar opposite of TD Garden. They did everything that was like the opposite of TD Garden.
Absolutely.
TD Garden did everything with consideration to like the stadium that was
before.
The aesthetic
of the fan.
I mean, it would be nice to go to Boston because it looks like it would be kind of cool to go to a Bruins playoff game during the summer. Yeah. Hang out by the river there.
So
look at
that.
4 years
ago. It's a keychain.
So it is the unanimous decision that we all think that the Barclay Center is the worst hockey arena
Which
ever.
Good riddance to when the island
is
moved
out. I mean, it just looks like an aquarium.
So I am a vomit. There you go. That's my description.
I would agree. I do want to go to Saddle Dome.
So my favorite arena
is.
I already know.
Is it KeyBank?
It is.
Is it the one we're going to in 5 days?
It is not that one. Overshot it.
It's KeyBank.
Yep, it is KeyBank Center. The reason I say that is I love Nashville, I love them for their atmosphere.
Yeah, okay.
I would have loved to have incorporated the concourses that we were just talking about into your exterior.
Yeah, theirs is nuts.
Yeah, so that would be
because
something
when you go when you look at this, when you see Alumni Plaza, it actually has a Buffalo Sabres Hall of Fame right in there.
Nice. Oh yeah, it's the Alumni Plaza. Yeah.
Stadium amenities or like stadium amenities plus like food or whatever would be kind of a cool one to do.
I mean, I do like Xcel Energy
Center.
I want to go to
more of them.
And then as far as like why I said this is my favorite is if you look at it, this you can tell purely made for hockey.
Hey, if you're right that the tickets are that cheap, that would be a pretty good game to go to.
Mm-hmm. All right, my least favorite.
Because it desecrated a classic.
Yeah.
And that, I'm sorry, that's a massive downplay on anything you try to replace it with. Yes, Little Caesars has a cool aesthetic.
It has some cool features.
But it will never
be. It has
be,
cool bells and whistles. But when
it
you
will
take
never
away,
be the Joe.
No. When you take away all those bells and whistles.
It's a sad arena.
Here's the thing.
It's the home of a bad
You
hockey
took
team.
Away the place where you made Detroit Hockey Town.
Yeah, that's kind of the way I feel about it.
You made, and that's the part where why I was trying to be unbiased with this, with not picking Nashville, because I do appreciate their atmosphere.
Yeah, you threw me a swerve there. I thought you were going to go to Nashville, be predictable.
Here's the thing, though, about Hockey Town, you got to remember, is marketing campaign before they even won either of the Cups. They started calling themselves Hockey Town as an answer to Green Bay calling Green Bay
Title Town.
So the titles actually made them Title Town, which they did in the show, which is kind of a cool thing to look into.
But just, this is a misstep of an arena. It did nothing to appreciate.
And it also does, and the same thing goes for this one.
Nah, don't even get me started. That's one that just, it makes me like internally like,
angry.
Sad. It just makes me sad.
Because it looks.
Rogers Place makes
a planetarium.
Me a sad panda.
It's a planetarium. But no, like when it comes to Little Caesars Arena, it's like you said, it's a total opposite.
For me, it was literally a toss-up between Little Caesars and Barclay, and I wanted to put Barclay, but after watching it get demolished, and me and Chris went to watch the final walkthrough that they did, and that they allowed these people
like, you're destroying this.
The abandoned fanatics. If you're an abandoned fanatic, there's several abandoned videos of Joe Louis Arena because you could just walk in there. They didn't care.
Yep.
You could have walked in there and walked away with a part of a piece of history.
Really?
Because here's the thing. I wish they did that with the Bradley Center.
I wish. Yeah, me too.
Like, they didn't even do anything to commemorate it. That place had how many events in there?
Yeah. The fact that they didn't even, like, use their brain power, like, the city could have made so much money selling, like, little chunks of the Bradley
Center.
What they did, it was on, like, some stupid website, but it was all auction type.
It
wasn't actual sale. It was just
and, like, and the Brewers were selling bricks of County Stadium, like, as recent as, like, less than a decade ago still, and still selling them.
Yep.
So, this has been from Milwaukee to Nashville.
I got a couple County Stadium bricks.
I got a comment challenge.
I can't remember. My parents got them.
Hold on a sec. I got comment challenges. So we all said our favorite arenas. We all said our dislikes. We all gave our intake. What's your intake? What's your favorite arena?
What's your least favorite arena? Least favorite and why?
Yeah. Or did you not agree with us? Why didn't you agree with us?
Yes, please comment.
We need comments. I'm actually generally curious to hear what people have to say.
Yeah, how dumb did I sound where, you know, like I was elaborating that maybe I didn't really have a well-thought-out comment.
What did you think of new Matt? Was old Matt better? Was old Matt worse? I need to know this thing, people. You can't sleep at night without knowing this stuff.
All right, guys, it's Brad.
So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on all of our videos. Click that bell to be notified every time we upload a video.
Yes.
We will see you guys later.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Bye-bye.
Yep.